First of all, the lack of humility from Donald Trump is breathtaking. But Steve Schmidt, we have to again, because I'm hoping that maybe some of my friends and family members who still think that Donald Trump is worthy of their vote will understand that he's lying to them nonstop. I mean, he says he inherited a bad hand on immigration, when in fact immigration has been going down, went down, I think, all 8 years of the Obama administration. You look at the fact that we have reverse immigration. We had reverse immigration going into Mexico because the Mexican economy had gotten stronger under Barack Obama. The economy growing every year under Barack Obama. I always talk, I ask people, Google GDP. World GDP of other countries. Compare other countries to ours. Not a close call. Not a close call. This country is strong and it's been moving upward. Make America great again. No, America had seven straight years of an exploding economy, of illegal immigration going down. Donald Trump actually inherited the best of all hands in those areas that he's now trying to screw up.
There's going to be no small number of soybean farmers who lose their farms generationally because of the trade war that Donald Trump has precipitated. Because when those markets dissipate, when they dry up, they're gone. The Chinese will be buying their soybeans from Brazil, for example.
China wins again.
But you look at his undermining of the U.S.-led liberal global order, his sundering of the Atlantic Alliance, his zero-sum sensibility that might makes right. He is moving the world into dangerous territory. And I think there's a real lack of imagination for the capacity for tragedy in the world caused by someone like this. But as we watch these rallies, what are we seeing? We are seeing somebody use lies to incite fervor in a base.
Yeah.
By the way, lies that are easily,
right?
Easily called out. You look at, like, we got to build a wall. We've got an illegal immigration. No, we don't. Actually, immigration down for 7-8 years. The president saying illegal immigrants cost us a lot of money. No, actually, illegal immigrants don't. There's a study that he demanded to get shows that refugees added $63 billion to our economy over the past decade. They killed the study.
But it's
immigrants cause crime. All these gang members come over. No, actually, it's 0.07%, something like 350 out of 300,000.
But it's a blizzard of lies.
Blizzard
where the
of
rapidity
lies.
Of lying is tough to stop and refute all of them. So we see incitement, the building of a fervor. We see scapegoating of vulnerable minority populations. We see the allegation of conspiracy, hidden nefarious forces conspiring with the scapegoated populations. We see a sense of mass victimization. It's the high octane fuel of Trumpism. Sean Hannity, Laura Ingraham, everybody's a victim. Now, they might be a victim flying around on their G650, but a victim they are nonetheless.
And then lastly, wealthy victims.
And last is his assertion that he needs to use extraordinary powers that heretofore were unthinkable.
We don't need judges.
To protect the victims from the conspiracy and the minorities
that he's created, right? A crisis that doesn't exist that he created throughout the campaign. And now I've got to say, you've got to add another one to that. That is just sheer stupidity.
Mm-hmm.
He goes to Greenville, South Carolina. He attacks the Germans, says they're dumping Mercedes and BMW. This would be the political equivalent of somebody campaigning in Pittsburgh. He goes, you know what, team sucks. God, the Steelers. I can't figure out whether I hate the Steelers more or the Penguins more or the Pirates more. Those colors just make me want to throw. That's the equivalent. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's that clear. BMW, because Carol Campbell had the vision to open up South Carolina to the world, it was a revolution. I saw Greenville.
It's an incredible city.
A renaissance. It's one of the great cities in America. And he went there and attacked Germans. You walk down the main street of Greenville on a Friday or Saturday night, guess what you hear spoken? German.
A lot of international headquartered companies in Greenville. Look, when we look at Trump right now, when we look at the Republican Party conservatism, there is only one requirement now: to be labeled a conservative in good standing. Absolute, total obedience to Trump. It doesn't matter what he says. And so in the 240th year of the independence of the United States, in three states by 78,000 votes, the American people, by a fluke, elected an imbecilic former reality TV show host and con man whose only affinity for reading anything were the Adolf Hitler speeches he kept on his nightstand. And so are we on the edge of a tragedy that will unfold from this? But America's decline is now beginning. And we should make no mistake about this. The U.S.-led liberal global order is in peril. It's in threat. Will he take us out of the World Trade Organization? Will he undermine the international system that Franklin Roosevelt conceived, that Harry Truman built, that was sustained through Ronald Reagan and Barack Obama? It's anyone's guess. But the idea that tomorrow will be okay because yesterday was or last year was is a naive view of the world.
Yeah. Well,
thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.